Saving and reloading a dataset. In this video, we'll take a look at saving a dataset in various formats and explore the ways to reload the saved data. When you download a dataset, the processing scripts and data are stored locally on your computer. The cache allows the dataset's library to avoid re-downloading or processing the entire dataset every time you use it. Now, the data is stored in the form of arrow tables, whose location can be found by accessing the dataset's cache files attribute. In this example, we've downloaded the Alicene dataset from the Hugging Face Hub, and you can see that there are three arrow files stored in the cache, one for each split. But in many cases, you'll want to save your dataset in a different location or format. As shown in the table, the dataset's library provides four main functions to achieve this. Now, you're probably already familiar with the CSV and JSON formats, both of which are great if you just want to quickly save a small or medium-sized dataset. But if your dataset is huge, you'll want to save it in either the arrow or parquet formats. Arrow files are great if you plan to reload or process the data in the near future, while parquet files are designed for long-term storage and are very space efficient. Let's take a closer look at each format. To save a dataset or a dataset dict object in the arrow format, we use the save to disk function. As you can see in this example, we simply provide the path we wish to save the data to, and the dataset's library will automatically create a directory for each split to store the arrow table and the metadata. Since we're dealing with a dataset dict object that has multiple splits, this information is also stored in the dataset dict JSON file. Now, when we want to reload the arrow datasets, we use the load from disk function. We simply pass the path of our dataset directory, and voila, the original dataset is recovered. If we want to save our datasets in the CSV format, we use the toCSV function. In this case, you'll need to loop over the splits of the dataset dict object and save each dataset as an individual CSV file. Since the toCSV function is based on the one from pandas, you can pass keyword arguments to configure the output. In this example, we've set the index argument to none to prevent the dataset's index column from being included in the CSV files. To reload our CSV files, we just then use the familiar load dataset function, together with the CSV loading script and the data files argument, which specifies the file names associated with each split. As you can see in this example, by providing all the splits and their file names, we've recovered the original dataset dict object. Now, to save a dataset in the JSON or Parquet formats is very similar to the CSV case. We use either the toJSON function for JSON files or the toParquet function for Parquet ones. And just like the CSV case, we need to loop over the splits to save each one as an individual file. And once our datasets are saved as JSON or Parquet files, we can reload them again with the appropriate script in the load dataset function. And we just need to provide a data files argument as before. This example shows how we can reload our saved datasets in either format. And with that, you now know how to save your datasets in various formats.